cafe by the cracker factory. You were practicing a magic trick, and my thoughts got rude as you talked and chewed on the last of your pick and mix. Said you're mistaken if you're thinking that I haven't been caught cold before, as you bit into your strawberry lace. Then a flip of your attention in the form of a gobstopper is all you have left, and it was going to waste. Your pastimes consisted of the strange, the twisted and deranged. I hate that little game you had called crying lightning, and how you like to aggravate the icky man on rainy afternoons. Uninvited, but not half as impossible as everyone assumes. Crying lightning.
Hey, Drue James here from learnguitarinlondon.com. And I'm playing an acoustic version of Crying Lightning by the Arctic Monkeys. This is a lesson that's been requested quite a lot, especially for some reason on the acoustic, which I think it works there really, really well. You'll have to excuse my slight skip up on the words. I'm still learning this song myself, actually. I can teach the guitar to it, but the vocals are like, they're quite fast in places. Anyway, this song's pretty easy if you're a beginner. There's a few chord changes in it, but most of them are open, and we've just got one rhythm pattern. This is taken from a video that they've made with an acoustic version. I've included that link in the video description so that you can, once you know the song, you can then start playing along with Alex and the band. So let's have a look at the left hand and learn how to play it. Let's go through the chords you're going to need for this song. They are A minor, mini bar F, E, G, and C. And then later on, we're also going to need a D minor as well. Okay, if you know those chords, then I've just included a link there in the video so you can skip in and get learning the video lesson, the song lesson straight away. If you don't, let's get started on them. So A minor, index finger on the first fret on the B string, middle finger on the second fret on the D, ring finger on the third fret on the G. If you don't know the names of the strings, Eddie 8, Dynamite, Goodbye, Eddie, E, A, D, G, B, E. And for that chord, you strum the bottom five strings. Make sure you strum in the sound. Okay, I'm only doing that to show you. Okay, F, so mini bar F. So you're gonna take the index finger, you're gonna lay it flat on the bottom two strings of the guitar. Press as hard as you can, point it towards your face, close to the fret marker, not back here towards the nut, and then middle finger on the second fret on the D string, G string, sorry. Ring finger on the third fret on the D string, and strum the bottom four. That's your F. We're then going to go to an E chord. So E chord from here, we're going to be index finger on the first fret on the G string, middle finger on the A string, and ring finger on the second fret on the D string. So we've got A string, second fret, D string, second fret. Strum all six. Cool. G. Index finger on the first fret on the A string, middle finger on the third fret on the E string. Ring finger tucked underneath on the third fret on the thinnest E string. Making sure this joint isn't doing this. It needs to be locked up. It's not the end of the world if it does that, but your muscles need to get stronger so they can do that. C chord. Index finger on the first fret on the B string. Middle finger on the second fret on the D string. And ring finger on the third fret, so three fret stretch, stretching over thumb around the back of the guitar, on the third fret on the A string. And strum bottom five. And finally, a D minor. So, index finger on the first fret on the E string, middle finger on the second fret on the G, and ring finger on the third fret, so sort of in the middle of these two fingers, on the B string, and strum the bottom four. Okay, so the rhythm guitar. Very simple, the rhythm guitar on this one. There's going to be a few little changes to it, but in fact, only one change, which is really, really easy as well. So we're going to go down, down, up, down, up, however, there's going to be times in the rhythm where we're going to be changing chord halfway through one of those rhythms, but I'll show you what to do there. So down, down, up, down, up, down. So let's have a look at the intro now, now we've got that rhythm. So it's down, down, up, down, up, down, up. So you see we're changing to the F. 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and. So we're changing to the F on the third down. Then we're going to go A minor, E. Once again, on the third down. From now I'm always going to call that half bar change. So you're changing halfway. It wouldn't be halfway if we were going... Okay, we're going... Okay, so there's A minor, E, then A minor, G, C, E. All half bar changes. I'll show you that intro again, because that's also the chord progression throughout all of the verses. So A minor, F, A minor, E, A minor, G, C, E. And then that's where your singing starts.
Outside the cafe by the cracker factory, we're practicing a magic trick. And my thoughts got moved as you talked and chewed on the last of your beginnings.
So you must stay in if you... I'm not going to keep going, but it's then just the same chords again. So always A minor F, A minor E, A minor G, C, E. Once again, play along to the records with that video link I've given you in the description of this video. Click on that and start playing along right away. It'll work. Okay, now when they get to the Your Past Times Consisted of the Strange, in my intro video, I did what they do the second time just because it sounds really cool and I like singing that bit. But what they do the first time when Alex is all very monotone with his singing voice and very low is you just make an A minor and you're going to just start changing your rhythm to just strum the top three strings and you're going to do eight, you're going to go 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. So along with the singing that goes, your past times consisted of the strange and twisted and deranged. I love that little game you had called crying lightning, and how you like to aggravate the ice cream man on rainy afternoons. And keep going. Strum the next time I caught my own reflection. Okay, so then we're just going to strum. Then we're going to start again on that chord progression. A minor
reflection, it was on its way to meet you, thinking up excuses to postpone.
Okay, but that same order, A minor F, A minor E, A minor G, C, E. And then, when we get to the second chorus, so it's the same words, but it's different chords. So it's your F times, but one bar of F, no changes in the middle.
Past times, D minor of the strange, A minor the deranged, A minor little game you I call F.
Into the instrumental at that point. I hope you're following that all through. From the F to the D minor, nice little quick tip on this is, just move that index finger down, and then the middle finger's already there, then the ring finger comes down. So it's a nice simple change. Okay, and then to A minor, just that finger up, middle and ring down. Now, we're into the instrumental. So to start with, we're just gonna do an A minor, going back into that similar idea that we had in Your Past Times, first time round.
And 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and
then we're going to play the same chords as the intro and the verse throughout the lead guitar solo. Then repeat that.
Your past times.
Then we're into the, sorry, this is the crying lightning part, so it's F.
Crying D minor,
A minor,
crying lightning,
F, same order of chords.
Past times consisted of the strange A minor and deranged. I A minor that gave you a chord.
Slow down, F.
Crying.
Finish on a slow strums D minor. Well done. Thanks a lot for watching my Arctic Monkeys lesson. I've made three other Arctic Monkeys lessons. I've just included some links here so that you can click on those and start watching them on YouTube straight away. Definitely the most popular one is Do I Wanna Know? So you should check that out. It's a nice and quick lesson, really cool, little fun, fast riff. You can also have a look at my website, learnguitarinlondon.com. There is over 150 free acoustic guitar lessons, all taught by myself there. So go and have a look, check it out. There's also a student area with tab and advice on how to become a better guitarist. Keep on playing. See you soon.